Good morning, students. Today we are going to start lesson 12, Compassion for Needy. So first of all, what is the meaning of compassion? Compassion means feeling of sympathy for someone suffering. So here in this chapter, we will learn that we should have a compassionate feeling for the needy people or those who are helpless. They need help. We should be compassionate towards them. Now let's move towards the text. India has produced many great men and women. Sant Tukaram of Maharashtra was one such person. He was a saint of highest order. He felt that the best way we can serve God is to help the poor and the needy. In recent times, Swami Vivekananda too laid great emphasis on serving the poor and the needy. He used to say, Nar Seva is Narayan Seva. That is, serving humankind is worship of God. So children, we know that in India we have numerous great men and women. Our freedom fighters, they give up their life for the freedom of their country. Means these people, they did not care only about themselves. They thought for the betterment of all people of their country. So Sant Tukaram of Maharashtra, he was also one such person. Okay, he was a saint and he preached that the best way to serve God is to help needy and the poor. Then Swami Vivekananda, he too laid emphasis on the same service of poor and needy. Swami Vivekananda used to say, Nar Seva is Narayan Seva. Nar Seva means service to humanity, humankind, is Narayan Seva, that is worship of God. So here we have a small incident of life of Sant Tukaram. So Sant Tukaram, he used to live in a village called Dehu. He was a very honest and sincere grocer. Means he used to sell the grocery items. So when he sold grocery items, he sold the goods at a very reasonable price, so that every people could buy it. And he had a very great feeling of compassion for poor and needy people. But this quality became his weakness, because many people of the village, they took advantage of it. They knew that Tukaram was full of compassion. Whatever they would ask, he would give them. So every day, someone or the other, they came to him and told him stories of their misfortune, that what problem they are facing, they are in lots of trouble and sorrow. And Tukaram was a very compassionate man. So listening to the stories, his heart got melted and he used to lend them money. Okay, so people, they were borrowing money from Tukaram and they were not giving it back. Some villagers, they bought the goods from the shop on credit. Means they were not paying the money and they were saying that they would pay it afterwards. And then after taking the goods, they would never pay the money. So villagers, they took wrong advantage of his generosity. And they took the advantage so much that his business went on loss, and ultimately Tukaram had to close his shop. Tukaram's wife, she was very hurt when she saw failure of Tukaram in his business. So, to start the business again, she sold all her jewels. Whatever jewelry she had, she sold all the jewels. And she encouraged her husband that he should go to some other village and start a new business. Here in this village, all the villagers knew him about his compassionate nature, and then again they would make use of this. So she advised him that he should go to another village and start a new business. So Tukaram, he liked his wife's advice. He left his village and went to some other village, and he started selling salt. So in this new business, he was successful in raising a large amount of money. So here he earned more than he earned in the previous shop. So now, after earning for some time, he decided that he would go back to his own village with that money. While he was going back to his village, he saw a group of people were beating a man. So the man was being beaten by so many people, he was crying in pain. Okay, the people were not showing any mercy on that man, and they were mercilessly beating him. Tukaram, when he saw this, he took part to save the poor man from the attackers. So he went there, he asked the people why they were beating the man. The villagers told him that Tukaram should not show mercy on this man, because the man used to borrow money from people and then he would not return the money back. So the villager told that they were the people who had borrowed him the, who had given him the money, or from them he had borrowed the money. They were the creditors and they wanted his money back. And they also wanted to teach him a lesson that he would never forget in future. And he would never think of borrowing the money and not giving it back. So when Tukaram saw this poor man, what difficulty he was facing, he asked the creditors how much money he owed, means how much money this man had to pay them. So all the creditors, they told him their amount, and Tukaram, he paid his money to rescue the old man. Then Tukaram accompanied the poor man to his house. When he went to his house, the sight of his family, or the pitiable condition of the family, made him compassionate. Or the children were crying for food. So this sight, it touched Tukaram's heart. He was so touched that whatever money was left after paying the creditors, Tukaram gave all the money to the family of poor man. So such was the compassionate nature of Tukaram. So afterwards, Tukaram became a singing saint. So here, the moral that we learn is, we may not always be able to do exceptional deeds, but there are thousands of small generous acts we can do to help others lift the load on the rough road of life. Okay, which means that we may not be able to do great things every time, but if we look around, we will always get thousands of opportunities to do small acts of kindness, which we can do to help others so that they can move smoothly in their road of life. Like see children, you are small children. Now what small deed you can do? Helping your friends, helping your family members, helping your neighbor. Means if you see your grandparents doing something, you can help them out. If your friends have not completed their notes, you can help them out. Okay, so we all should be compassionate towards others. Each small deed of compassion will help the other person lead a smooth life. And also, if we are compassionate towards others, someday or later, if we need help, other people would also help us. I hope the chapter is clear to all. Go through the book once. Okay, thank you, children.